Welcome to Live Event News New York. I'm Charlie Mann. Are we ready for a triple play, New York? Are we ready? I'm talking about the WWE Hard Attack World Tour. Meadowlands Arena this Thursday night. Nassau Coliseum this Friday night. And we complete the hat trick in Madison Square Garden Saturday night, October 29th, 1 week from tonight. Now, I'm in the WWE Hard Attack World Tour spirit. As you can see, I got my graveyard section right here. Stay right there. And my WWE Hard Attack World Tour t-shirt and my casket. Are you in the spirit, New York? Let's go right to the matches. How about the Bob Backlund Challenge? The Mr. Bob Backlund Challenge. Can anybody, and I mean anybody, break out of the chicken wing? The Duke, the Dumpster Drozdy, will try to put IRS in the trash can. We will see this match. Atom Bomb, the master of the Atom Smasher, Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, on the other side. How about tag team action? The Smoking Guns, Bart and Billy, will try to smoke past the Heavenly Bodies. How about Doink, who will have Dink in his corner against Jerry the King Lawler with a queasy in his corner. Kind of funny, huh? As we move on, Lex Luger, made in the USA, will face his former buddy, Tatanka. Championship match, Bret the Hitman Hunter, fighting his champ ever in the WWF. He will face Jim the Anvil Neidhart, his brother-in-law, and the unbelievable casket match. This is Undertaker and Yokozuna. The winner has to throw the loser in a ringside casket and slam the lid. Yeah. That's the sign the Undertaker's near. We better get the tickets before The Undertaker's here. They will be available at all arena box offices and all Ticketmaster outlets. Now, we all know there's a baseball strike. We all know there's a hockey lockout. WWF, there's no strike or lockout. Let's get right to those great dates. Okay, this Thursday night, Meadowlands Arena. Friday night, Nassau County Coliseum in Long Island. Saturday night, Fever in Manhattan. We complete the hat trick. October 29th, 1 week from tonight.
Action, and we have a guest ring announcer.
Oh, not again.
Special guest ring announcer.
Oh, look at that pair.
From Hopewell Junction, New York, Mario Marioni.
Mario Macaroni.
All right, and this contest is scheduled for one fall.
Like this chin so much, he's added another one.
From Sunnyside, New York, weighing at 237 pounds, Chris Canyon.
Chris Canyon. What's his name? Mario Mariani, I believe it was.
Yeah, go stick a feather in your hat and call it whatever his name is.
You know, you can't be nice to anyone, can you?
Look at this kid here.
I'd like to see Bob back in the fly the cross-face chicken wing on you.
Oh, no. Mm-hmm. I'd like to see him get it on the 1-2-3 kid, though. Whoa, hey.
And the kid backing Canyon to the corner.
You know, I'd like to see that match, actually. That'd be a great match.
What's that?
The 1-2-3 kid, unquestionably part of the new WWF generation, against Bob Backlund.
I thought you liked the 1-2-3 kid.
I do. Canyon now with a standing side headlock.
Why would you want to see his career ended, cut short?
I don't know that would necessarily be the case. Oh. And a tackle there. Down goes the kid.
There you go. Look at this Canyon. I like him.
And unquestionably, the 1-2-3 kid outweighed, generally speaking, out-muscled by many of the WWF competitors out today.
I know, I was going to say, don't tell the kid, but somebody put toothpicks where his legs were supposed to be.
Oh, you're right. And down goes the 1-2-3 kid.
Look at this guy.
Extremely resourceful.
Hey, that guy sort of reminds me of Razor Ramon.
Who's this?
This Canyon guy.
Oh, really? In what respect?
Well, he likes to use a toothpick on his teeth there, and I think that's why I got this match with the 1-2-3 kid. Reminds him of a toothpick.
Look at this. Right now, Canyon is all over the 1-2-3 kid.
Yeah.
Sets him up now to the far side. Oh, misses him with a roundout, and the kid. Oh, the kid with a slide.
Look out.
The kick to the... Look at that maneuver. Unbelievable. And that's how the kid evens the score out, even when he doesn't have a size or a strength advantage. Look at that maneuver. Unbelievable. Let's go back, take another look now, ladies and gentlemen, the double feature. On the left side of the screen, you'll see what we just saw.
I want to take a look at what's going on right now, McMahon.
1-2-3 kid now. Unbelievable maneuver.
McMahon, let me tell him what's going on right now.
Would you please? Now, we have to get this straight. All right, now to the buckle. Canyon, 1-2-3.
Oh, my
goodness, the kid ran into it. Now look at this.
Hey!
High risk maneuver. It's Chris Kenny on the top end. Father, nobody home. And a smile on the kid's face. Now the kid to the outside.
A smile on that pimply face. Kid's face.
So 1, 2, 3, kid on the top rope. Kenyon stays. Kenyon spins in a flying drop kick from way up above. A cover. Is that enough? 2, and yes, it is. 1, 2, 3, kid victorious. And standing by, King Kong Bundy in action. Plus Native American Tatanka, the British Bulldog, and a heartbreak hotel. Stay with us.
Beginning Sunday, October 23rd, this is the WWF Action Zone.
What a hit, man. That is definitely highlight material.
This isn't.
If they don't red dog down in the red zone, that O will run a 928 blue in the left flat and put a quick six against that dime D.
This is WWF Action Zone.
What a move! He can go all the way!
This isn't.
I know this is a real personal question, but I have to ask this anyway. What is your favorite breakfast cereal?
Cornflakes. I mean, bran flakes.
Tune in the action. Tune out the talk. The WWF Action Zone. Welcome to the new generation.
Can I change that to Captain Crunch?
Yes, indeed, it's the Action Zone. The action beginning this Sunday afternoon at 12 noon. The WWF champion, Bret Hart, against his brother, the last time ever. Owens will have a shot at the title. But speaking of action, take a look who is following Ted DiBiase's money trail. Look at this. Jerry the King Lawler. There's another king.
You're right.
King Kong Bundy.
King Kong Bundy. Look at him. Would you believe, McMahon, I got pictures of him when he only weighed 120 pounds?
Kidding.
No, it's his baby pictures. Take a look at him. He's huge.
He is the biggest asset today to the corporation, no doubt about that.
I can guarantee you the million-dollar man is expecting him to pay some huge dividends.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
All right, it's John Crystal to meet the massive King Kong Bundy. Look at the neck on Bundy.
Listen, he's talking to you, McMahon.
King Kong Bundy is back. Yeah, take a look at his back. Huge Bundy against John Crystal, wasting no time at all. And, oh, what an uppercut that was. And Crystal is rocked. As anyone would be, back to the corner now. Look at Bundy. Look at the size differential. Oh, what a shot.
Wow.
King Kong Bundy pouring it on. Bundy taking over Crystal, manhandling, and yes, it's all about the dollars. Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man, the corporation, growing ever stronger. Although I would suspect that Bundy could very well throw a wrench into the corporation. I would suggest that Bundy could actually be a problem to some of the other members of the corporation.
Now that you mention it, he has
jealousy.
No. The only problem that he's caused is when they all get on the corporate jet to fly to these major cities, well, the weight of King Kong Bundy has the jet actually leaning to one side. You have to get Bam Bam Bigelow, you have to get Tatanka, IRS, and DiBiase all have to sit on the other side of the jet.
Ooh!
Just to equal the weight of the massive King Kong Bundy. That's the only problem so far.
A count of three. No count there at all. Bundy's not finished yet. With his opponent, John Crystal.
Toying with him.
The corporate jet. Is it the corporate jet or is it the corpulent jet? To the bunker, and Bundy uses his huge size to his advantage.
And quit trying to use big words like Bob Backlund.
A cover here, and look
he
at
got
this.
Him.
No, he insists on a 5 count.
That's right. You know why?
Why?
I found out that Kid gives him a little extra bonus when he holds him down for a count of five.
I see.
It involves the number five. I'm not going to tell you how many zeros go behind it.
Let's go back now and take another look, ladies and gentlemen, at some of the action.
Everybody,
Bundy very proud of himself. Here we go now. Bundy setting up John Crystal. Go! Devastating maneuver by the walking condominium. He's something else.
King Kong Bundy, all you superstars in the World Wrestling Federation will rule. Bye-bye.
This Sunday, the King of Hearts, Owen, will get one last chance at Bret's title.
Everybody remembers what happened at WrestleMania 10. Owen shocked the world by upsetting the Hitman. But it was Bret Hart who went on to win the WWF Championship later that night, and Owen could only watch and wonder what might have been. Owen Hart went on to become the King of the Ring and earned a shot at Bret's title at SummerSlam inside that steel cage. And it was a classic battle, but this time, the Hitman came out on top to retain the title. Then the Anvil, as you see here, padlocked the gate and took his frustrations out on the Hitman. The British Bulldog came to his rescue, and the rest is history. A family torn apart, inside the ring and out. Owen has one last chance this Sunday.
This is your last chance for the title.
But you've already beaten him!
That's right, Bret, and I'm gonna beat you again. Now everything's falling right into place, just like I planned, Bret. And this may be my last chance, but your last time as WWF champion.